comes back and says, I'm not going to tell him that. He might just use that to his advantage. And then Clint comes back and says, yeah, maybe you're right.
Yeah, I think you're right too, Dave. That's probably a smart move. Don't show him your weakness or tell him where it's at, because he'll definitely go for it.
Well, Dave, were you talking about how he was trying to learn strategies running both races and learning in-race strategy?
Well, and part of the problem going back and forth is that sometimes you forget which car you're doing what to, but you try to apply what you can. In fact, during the first caution, owner Richard Childress was talking with Clint, hey, buddy, that low line is really working for you, isn't it? And Clint was saying, yes, it was. And you know they were talking about, couldn't we apply some of this to our cup car tomorrow, which, as you guys have mentioned, isn't running quite as quick as the two car today.
Good point. Denny Hamlin trying to work on Kevin Harvick for second.
And once again, Clint Bowyer, the two car, after a few laps, starts putting distance on that second place car.
Update on Reed Sorensen in the 41 car from Matt.
Well, running in the fifth position, the 41 car, as he works the inside of the 60. Now, Wally touched on it earlier. It seems like Reed is better on the back half of the first run. They made some air pressure adjustments, lacking balance-wise grip on both the front and the back of the car. Too tight in the center, but too free on exit. They hope they improved on that with the air pressure adjustment. Meanwhile, talking about the 21 of Harvick, right as they had that restart, we were going back and forth with conversations with his teammate. He said, you know, I'm not going to wait here very long. But then the two cars really came in. You can see him pull out a little bit of distance there, Wally.
Yeah, it looks like the 21 car's really good on the first five or six laps after a start or a restart, but he just looks like he loses grip in the front of the car.
Kurt Busch runs sixth, then it's Blaney, Sauter, McMurray, and Greg Biffle rounding out the top 10. Behind race leader Clint Bowyer, Kevin Harvick, Denny Hamlin, Reed Sorensen, and Carl Edwards. NASCAR Busch Series Racing from New Hampshire International Speedway on TNT is brought to you by Carfax. Never buy a used car without Carfax. Get a Carfax vehicle history report, ask your dealer, or go to Carfax.com. By Crestor, visit Crestor.com and ask your doctor if Crestor is right for you. And by TGI Fridays Restaurants, introducing seven amazing new dishes on our new entree menu. Everyone could use more Fridays. Clint Bowyer leads by about a second and a half. Races for second right now. Kevin Harvick in the 21. Denny Hamlin in the 20.
And Hamlin is getting that low line to work for this 20 car. Kind of like the two of Clint Bowyer, but not well enough to get by Kevin Harvick.
So Harvick is watching Bowyer pull away.
Oh, trouble off turn four.
Tracy Hines is involved.
That's Peyton Sellers sitting there behind Tracy Hines. And the zero of Curtis Davis also drives away from that crash.
Caution number four. There's Sellers, the 31 machine. Let's see what we can see here.
Never see the three cars all running together, and Tracy Hines just gets in the back of the 31 car.
Oh my
goodness.
And had some company in the door.
Man, man. That's Curtis Davis in the zero, about flipped.
That's a wild ride.
It is. He's still continuing around the racetrack.
His heart's beating a little faster. Pit road remains closed, so we'll take a break. Fourth caution of the day at New Hampshire. Clint Bowyer is the race leader. You're watching NASCAR on TNT. Still under caution, and BP, here's another look at why.
What in the world looks like all of a sudden that Hines and the 12 car just, the car turned right?
It almost looks like a little bit of frustration to me, because he really drove up the racetrack into the 31 car.
And Curtis Davis, an innocent victim. Still under caution for track cleanup here at New Hampshire with 83 laps complete. Well, they tried to sneak in a couple of laps of green flag racing, but they didn't get too far before Jason Leffler brought out the caution.
Spun around up in 3 and 4. Doesn't look like a lot of damage to this 38 car. If you watch him go in the corner, Hockey Vidovich, the 4 car, goes up and just makes contact with him.
He was trying to squeeze in between 2 cars and they ran out of room.
Yeah.
Another look here.
I guess that was a 0 car that Augie was trying to squeeze between the 38 and the 0.
On board with J.J. Yaley.
Looks like the 4 car got loose. And then ran into Leffler.
McFarland is the lucky dog this time. Scott Wimmer was the lucky dog on the previous caution. And part of the cause of that could have been they got all jammed up about third on back when they were racing for a position. Under caution here at New Hampshire, our fifth of the day. Green flag has just come out the field into turn one. Clint Bowyer is the race leader, but keep your eye on the 21 and the 20, Harvick and Hamlin. They had an exchange on the previous restart and then showed some displeasure under caution.
And Hamlin is going to try to go by on the outside. Is Harvick going to run him up the hill?
I would say so, BP.
Looks that way.
That is what you call running somebody up the hill. Fortunately, they're going to lose a couple of spots forward. That car lapped down.
That car's a lap down.
Walter, yes. Yep.
But Sorensen is trying to get in there. That's not going to work.
Sorensen.
Slow motion spin.
Oh, and that's it.
Yeah.
Stephen Light, the 90 car, comes along and hits the 41. The 64 McMurray backs her in turn one wall.
And that all started with one guy running another guy up the racetrack.
Yeah, because they had issues.
And that's pretty much happened on the previous restart as well.
Yes.
With the 21 on the 20.
Here we go. They're 3 wide. Carl Edwards, a 60 car. Here comes Kyle Busch. Boys, they just don't fit. I mean, 3 abreast at New Hampshire. Well, it doesn't fit.
Now, usually the guy in the middle should back out when you're in a situation like that, because if you don't, that's what happens. The guy in the middle is normally going to pay. Well, the guy on the outside, but that could have been avoided.
Matt.
Bill, the spotter's running back and forth on the roof. Now, a little earlier, Harvick, as you're watching the replay, looking back at the 41 of Sorensen and the 20 of Hamlin, Harvick asked his spotter to tell Hamlin, please do not wreck me on the straightaway. Hamlin's response was, tell him that if he cuts me off turn two again, I'm going to dump him. And Harvick said, well, if you do that, ready. Then you better be ready. And then you can see what transpired after that.
It kind of started with Hamlin giving Harvick a little shove down the backstretch.
Yeah,
letting him know he was there.
It was more than a little shove. I mean, it looked like he hit the rear wheels off the ground of Kevin Harvick's car.
All right, let's go back and take a look.
Okay, watch a 20 car. He'll drive up underneath Harvick, and he gives him a pretty good shot right there. And then you'll see Denny go to the high side, and Harvick didn't like that much. He's just turning the wheel to the right now.
This was about 4, 5, or 6 laps ago.
And then the caution came out for Jason Leffler.
That's right.
And this was under caution after the yellow flag for Leffler.
Yeah, Hamlin pulled out. He didn't appreciate getting run off the racetrack in 3 and 4, so. So these guys, okay, so now we're under yellow and they're mad at each other. So you just know something's gonna happen under the next restart.
Dave.
And Denny Hamlin, when he got run up the racetrack, on I guess it was the second time when he was passing this last green flag run, said, I can't pass him much cleaner than that. That was right before this caution came out. He had settled down definitely coming from everybody. The left front fender, though, is something Denny Hamlin has to have his team keep an eye on. That was damaged in some of these exchanges here, so I'll have to watch that. Just a little crinkle, it looks like.
Yeah, it's okay.
NASCAR has warned the drivers of car 20 and 21, Denny Hamlin and Kevin Harvick, to settle down on the racetrack.
That damage on the left front came when he made contact to the 41 and Reed Sorensen. That's where that damage came from.
Update on the pole sitter from Allen.
Yeah, we saw Kyle Busch in the jam up there trying to avoid Reed Sorensen. Looked like he might have just gotten a glancing blow off the 41 car when he got by. Kyle has pulled up beside Denny Hamlin. They've had Denny look at the right front tire of the 5 car to see if it might be going down because Kyle thought he had a vibration. They have determined that they're okay, that maybe Kyle just got some debris on his tire from running down on the apron of the racetrack, and he should be just fine, so they'll stay out and not pit.
93 laps are complete, with 19 cars currently scored on the lead lap.
We ran 60 laps, green flag.
Yeah, we did.
Hard to believe.
Oh, it is hard to believe. I don't think we're going to run 60 more laps.
Well, everyone will be watching Harvick, who restarts second in the 21 car. Hamlin is fourth. In the 20 car, Carl Edwards. In between him in third. Bowyer, the race leader, the green is out.
Yeah, Carl Edwards might be the best thing in the world that happens to Harvick and Hamlin. He's the buffer.
Try to clear the 27 car of David Green.
Harvick, taking a look, but I'll tell you what, I don't think anybody can get underneath that 2 car right now.
How about Carl, AB? Hey, Bill, you know, sometimes when we're watching a race or people watching a race at home, you can sort of see things happening, right?
Right.
Well, Carl Edwards saw all of that happening, even without the benefit of hearing all the radio traffic that we were between Kevin Harvick and Denny Hamlin. He was very aware when that last restart happened that something might break loose in front of him. He was on the wheel, ready to anticipate, avoided it, picked up a spot in the process, and has a clean race car to continue trying to win.
Always paying attention, you driver.
Well, yeah, when you start driving, ooh, a little loose there for Harvick. He's going to possibly lose a spot. Carl Edwards in the 60 car.
Oh, and look who's right behind the 21. Denny Hamlin's going to try and pass him on the inside as well.
A little loose, lost it. But yeah, when you're watching stuff like that, you know when a driver's jacking with another driver. You know when there's an issue going on, just the way the guys drive each other, like driving somebody up the racetrack like that. So. And you like it because you think they're going to take each other out or give you a couple of spots when they're messing around with each other.
There's Hamlin on the inside of Harvick. Going to try it again.
And once again, Kevin Harvick got loose the same spot that he got loose a moment ago. And this time, Harvick does not fight him. He does a slide job on him.
You cannot get much closer to the guy's rear bumper than that.
Hamlin gets the position. Harvick loses the spot. But also, kind of, does it take your focus off your main objective?
Yeah, because you just want to get the other guy.
So Carl Edwards was...
That's exactly right, Kevin. We believe you. That was Kevin Harvick telling Todd Barrier.
A lot of talk this weekend in both the Cup and the Busch Garage about paybacks in NASCAR racing. Be a subject on our Bank of America Countdown to Green tomorrow, coming off the wild finish at Chicagoland last week in the Nextel Cup Series. And Jeff Gordon got into the rear bumper of Matt Kenseth. Gordon went on to win the race. Much more on that tomorrow on the Bank of America Countdown to Green.
Now all of a sudden, the 20 car Denny Hamlin seems to be struggling to find speed.
BP, I think he just slipped that one lap off to that last lap. I saw him go high up on the racetrack, and it looked like he just lost a little time there.
Alan, what are you learning down there?
Well, Bill, we just crossed the about to cross the halfway point of this race, and it turns the event now for the crew chiefs down here on pit road into a game of strategy. Should we see a caution in these next 10 laps, it really puts the crew chief on the bubble of a decision. Do I pit? Will I get enough caution laps to make it to the finish? Or as Carl Edwards' crew chief told me this morning, is my car handling bad enough that I'll have to pit later on in the race, or will it be good enough to hold my position on the track? Last year, Denny Hamlin, pictured there, stopped right at this point in the race, got enough cautions to make the finish, although the handling on his car deteriorated in the final laps where he was passed by Martin Truex, who had pressure tires with 12 laps to go. Big worry time for the crew chiefs down here now. If you see a caution out in the next few laps, do they pit? Can they make it to the finish?
But fun for us, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Then you really get to see what happens when a calculator starts to smoke.
Clint Bowyer, the race leader, by about a half a second over Carl Edwards, Denny Hamlin, Kevin Harvick, and Kyle Busch. Past the halfway mark, what's going to happen next? You'll find out live on TNT. Clint Bowyer has raced off to nearly a two-second lead over Carl Edwards. Denny Hamlin runs third, Kevin Harvick fourth, and Kyle Busch fifth here in New Hampshire. Sunoco and TNT are teaming up to offer fans a chance to win 10,000 gallons of free gas with the Free Fuel 5000 sweepstakes. Go to freefuel5000.com and get details.
How many gallons? 10,000?
10,000 gallons.
That's a lot of money.
Well, it's Benny's favorite word.
Free?
Yes, sir. So Bowyer has had an outstanding car throughout the race, and you can see it right there. 94 of the 109 laps.
Look at the tires when they're even going down the straightaway. The pressures are so low in these things to try to get these cars down to the racetrack, get them on the track. They look like they have flat tires.
Kyle Busch led the other 15 laps.
You know, after a caution flag, they're able to run with this two car for four or five laps, and then it's no contact. There you see that left front tire almost flat, Wally, and the left rear.
How many laps before those come back up?
They won't come. That's about as high as they're going to get right there.
That's it.
Dave?
I heard you guys talking about that issue under caution, and I went up to Dan Deeringhoff, the crew chief, and I said, Dan, did you get all the air in the left front? He just smiled. They know they're running them low, but that is the way that you got to set up these cars these days. Of course, it builds pressure during the run, but as you see, it's still pretty low.
Now, does it have a funny feeling in those first few laps?
The first few laps, it's kind of feels like your tires are squishy, but then once you get some heat in them, they grip. Obviously, they're gripping around that two car because that thing just looks unbelievable right now.
112 laps are complete. Clint Bowyer continues to lead, and we'll take you through the rest of the field when we come back to New Hampshire. Bowyer, Edwards, Hamlin, Harvick, and Busch. Clint Bowyer in that two car has 9 top tens and 19 races this season and only 2 finishes worse than 18th. He hasn't been to victory lane since October of last year at Memphis, but he is out front and dominating this afternoon in New Hampshire. Let's take you through the field, starting with Dave Burns.
And Bill, talking to his crew chief earlier today, I commented on the great qualifying run today. But he said, you know what, it wasn't easy getting there. I'm tearing my hair out and during practice sometimes with Clint. We weren't good during practice. We made all kinds of changes. We also did that at Phoenix, a race we led in this car. Seemed to be working again. Alan?
Carl Edwards is running second. He called into his team on the radio a little while ago, said, I'm just going to ride here for a while and let the number two car burn his stuff down in front of me. Well, you can interpret that two ways. That was either a polite way of saying I can't run with him or a little bit of racing strategy there, Dave.
Alan, Denny Hamlin seems to have settled down a little bit after the earlier confrontation, but I think he knows who's in his rearview mirror. He's commenting on the car, just a little bit tight in the center of the corner. Won't turn as well as he likes, but for now, he's holding his position. Alan?
Dave, the 21 of Harvick has reeled in the 20 of Hamlin, looking down to the bottom, then easing back up to the outside. He's led over 400 laps here, but he's never won here on the Magic Mile. Now, Harvick's car was loose. You heard him say that on the radio. Owner Richard Childress told him to change his line a little bit and give him some other advice. It seems to his health. Alan?
Earlier in the race, Kyle Busch had his team put a spring rubber in the right rear of his car to help its handling after a fairly lengthy debate over to make that time-consuming adjustment or do something else. Kyle called in a while earlier, said, you're probably going to hate me for this, but I might want you to take that back out. We'll see if they choose to do it and give up some spots on the pit stop. Paul Menard has moved his way up from 24th starting position to where he runs now solidly in the top 10. This 25-year-old from Eau Claire, Wisconsin, recently completed a climb from one of the sport's rising stars to its most recent new winner.
Paul Menard looking for his first career victory.
Paul Menard works his way back into turn three for the final time.
Eau Claire, Wisconsin, Paul Menard wins tonight in front of the home crowd at the Milwaukee Mile.
It's the most fun racing I've ever done. I'd like to do that again sometime this coming winter. I've played football for 7 years, and it's tough. You know, we'd play our games Friday night, then leave to go to Minnesota or somewhere to race our legend car on Saturday night, and I always had my thumbs broke or something was taped up on me trying to drive one-handed, so it was tough.
Paul trying to follow up that first NASCAR Busch Series victory with another one here today. He's risen from 25th into the top 10 and having a great run, Marty.
Allen, in order to be fast here at New Hampshire, your car must cut in the middle of the corner, meaning it must turn for Dave Blaney. It just will not do that right now. The car is a handful at this point. He told him, the crew, fellas, we're going to need a big change if we're going to get up to the front and keep up with these guys. Nice, solid top 10 day, though. Chasing him down, Johnny Sauter. Very fast in the middle part of this run. He said the back end of this car is just sliding all over the place, but the last adjustment she made for me really helped the car. Currently, Sauter is in the eighth position. How about this run for Scott Riggs? A moment ago, I mean, literally like 25 laps ago, he was back in 17th. Now he's charged to the field. He's in ninth. He said the car is a little bit loose off the corners. Can't be aggressive with the gas like you would like, but he is charging up to the field, Matt.
Rounding out the top 10 is Jeff Burton in the 77 car. Crew chief Gene Need made a great call back on lap 82. Burton's water temperature had climbed to 250. They pitted, took tape off the grill to get more air in to cool the water down. Also, they made a wedge adjustment. The car too free by itself, but too tight in traffic. Burton says it's gotten better, but they still have a lot of work to do, AB.
Yeah, J.J. Haley probably feels the same way about his car. A lot of work to do on that because he just haven't been able to get it where he can move up through traffic as we check that race for second place. Kevin Harvick, 21. Denny Hamlin, 20. Let's see if it's a clean pass or if they tangle a little more here. What do you think, guys?
I think they're racing pretty clean, and that's what I said earlier. I think they got it out of them system. They both have cooled down now, and as long as they race each other clean and they stay this way, I don't think there'll be any problems.
Go ahead and pick it up on the 18 there, Alan.
Yeah, passes can take a while to happen here in New Hampshire, huh? Just talking about J.J. Yaley, Hamlin's teammate, just haven't been able to get his car adjusted where he can move up through traffic. So they continue to work on that number 18 car, hoping they can get it where they can come up with a top five finish. Scott Wimmer, as we continue going through the field in the box on the left side of the screen. Here's a car that was a lap down earlier in the race, that 66 machine. He started 20th, got put a lap down, but he got the lucky dog at lap 79, pitted at lap 81, made adjustments to the car. He's moved himself up inside the top 15. Matt?
Top of your screen, the 41, Reed Sorensen running 13th, rebounding well. The car cosmetically looks a little rough, but not running too badly after that spin. His car a little crazy, he says, for the first three or four laps in the beginning of a run, but then it shatters the right rear on that 41 of Sorensen, looking for a second straight top 10. Marty?
Well, Matt, even after the damage earlier on, Jason Leffler turning some fairly good lap times. There was not a whole lot of damage on the 38 car. They slapped some fresh tires back on it, sent him on the racetrack. He does, as we said, have fresher tires than most of the other teams, but turning some pretty impressive lap times right now, Dave.
Marty, Mark McFarland is back in the 88 car, missed two races because of a wreck at Milwaukee, had physical therapy done to his shoulder. He told me today I had three options. They could make they could do surgery on it, I could have physical therapy, or I could do nothing. I'm really glad I chose PT because they worked me hard, and I haven't felt bad at all in the car this whole weekend.
Thanks, guys. That's the top 15. Then it's Biffle, Wallace, Waltrip, and Todd Cleaver rounding out the 19 cars on the lead lap. Boyer leads by a little over 4 seconds over Carl Edwards, but the Denny Hamlin, Kevin Harvick thing has been a blast to watch. Boyer out front, Edwards is second. We'll watch the rest of them as we take a break from New Hampshire. You're watching the NASCAR Busch Series live on TNT. TNT Sports live at the New Hampshire International Speedway in Loudoun, New Hampshire. There is the race leader, Clint Boyer, 4 seconds ahead of Carl Edwards. And Kevin Harvick now runs second. And Denny Hamlin, check that, back to third, and Denny Hamlin is fourth. So it's Boyer, Edwards, Harvick, Hamlin, and then Kyle Busch, your top five.
And all of a sudden, Boyer, the two car, having trouble passing Todd Cleaver in 06. Cleaver is the last car on the lead lap. He is 19th.
And if you start having trouble here, this is where these guys will really cut into your lead. And this is where Boyer's got to be really patient, not make a mistake, and get into somebody right now. And it's frustrating because you know you're faster. But then again, Cleaver's not wanting to go a lap down. So, I mean, they're all, you know, they're all racing for a reason.
Just got pinched in there behind the wounded 35. Alan?
And one of the things that's going on, Bill, with that 06 car is his team knows that Clint Boyer's not far away from making a green flag pit stop. They know if they can keep their man out in front of Boyer, he's going to peel off and they're going to get a little cushion going here because they can run farther on fuel.
Boyer last stopped on lap 57. getting close to his pit window, as Alan pointed out. Tear Up the Highway with the new Smokey and the Bandit Special Edition DVD. It's in stores now.
Well, that could mix things up if these guys that pitted on lap 57 were to make a pit stop. And then we've had several cautions since. Several cars have made a pit stop. They stay on the racetrack. Then the caution flag comes out and catches these guys a lap down. Boy, these NASCAR races are so hard to win.
But Bowyer, Edwards, Harvick, Hamlin, Kyle Busch have not stopped since lap 57.
Yeah, if anything, they'd like to see the yellow come out.
Right, because the pit window is a little under 100 laps, around 95 or so, basically. And they've gone, they're closing in on 90 right about now. There's Harvick in third, and let's show you how he got there.
We saw him race underneath the 20 car of Denny Hamlin several times. And up in three and four, once again, Harvick was on the inside of Denny Hamlin, and Wally, when he came off turn four, the 20 car got a little bit loose, had to squeeze out of the gas.
But they had a good race. They were racing side by side for five or six laps and raced each other clean.
Harvick about 8.5 seconds behind the race leader.
So they Harvick's did. Running pretty good lap times. I know some of these guys are in traffic right now, but if Kevin's car is coming into him a little bit better than the last run, or Bowyer and Edwards are just in a lot of traffic.
We're working lap 140. Harvick's about 9 seconds behind the race leader. 60 to go. Kevin with the huge lead.
Now, you know, Kevin was really complaining about the car being loose after the pit stops they made, but it looks like it gone back to the push aside. It looks very tight right now.
Matt?
Bill, it has tightened up. In fact, four laps ago, Kevin told his crew chief, Todd Barrier, I want a small adjustment. Earlier, they were looking at making a significant, maybe wedge and air pressure adjustment. Now they're looking for just a small air pressure adjustment because the car has tightened up, not as free as it once was.
And I think probably, Matt, they don't want to go too much just because he really had his hands full, you know, on that restart. So if they make another big change, he's going to be way too loose for those first 10 or 15 laps.
Somebody wants their driver on pit road. Start to say Harvick with a big lead in the championship standings, over 300 points over Carl Edwards. And Clint Bowyer, the race leader, heading for his pit stall on lap 143. He's got a long way to go, but he's heading for you, Dave.
And Bill, you mentioned it last time in lap 57 for the glove save that wasn't a beauty. He hasn't said anything about changing the car. We suspect they're just going to put more tires on the car, perhaps a slight air pressure adjustment to make sure he doesn't tighten up near the end of this run, but he hasn't asked for anything. Car running extremely well. Four tire change for the leader. AB.
And Kyle Busch will follow the leader down pit road. This is about seven laps sooner than they were planning on pitting, but they don't want to give up the speed on fresh tires to the leader. They pull a strip of tape off the grill. They'll make an adjustment to the track bar, and they look to pull a spring rubber back out of the right rear that they put in before. Good work so far for the Hendrick team and Kyle Busch. A lot of work on this green flag pit stop, as a matter of fact.
Taking a long time, too.
Yeah, well, that's a lot to do, Bill. You want to pull that rubber back out and make the track bar adjustment. The same guy has to do both of those things.
No, Alan, the caution flag comes out.
Car in the wall in turn four.
Caution down.
Aaron Fike in the 33 car has spun. What did I say about Clint Bowyer making that pit stop and then the caution flag would have come out?
Not good.
His worst nightmare came true.
Would he be the lucky dog, though?
Don't know.
Have to wait and see.
I bet you he's a lucky dog.
He is.
Well, then, how blessed?
Lucky guess.
He's going to stay on the racetrack. All the other cars, he'll be leading.
Exactly.
Dave?
It came out at the right time for him. Sorry, Dave.
No, that's okay. His words after that caution flag came out, though, guys. Now what? And, of course, he was the lucky dog, so it got better.
Second time Aaron Fike has brought out the caution today.
Looks like Mike Wallace, the one car, might have gotten in the back of him going in turn three in the middle of the corner.
Didn't hit anything.
Kept it off the wall. There's another angle. It's already underway here. A We'll have to wait and see where Kyle Busch comes out in the scoring as well. Currently scored one lap down.
Well, there can only be one lucky dog, so we know one of those guys is going to be a lap down. Marty?
Well, Scott Riggs was awfully fast in the middle part of that run, guys. He's in about a 6.5 tight on a scale of 1 to 10, down up two rounds on the track bar, rather a pound on the right rear tire, trying to loosen that car up. Matty?
You can see how much these drivers are using brakes by looking at the front tires on Harvick. Small air pressure till they backed up what they did on the car before because the car was tight the first run.
Bottom of your screen, Denny Hamlin already leaving pit road. They made a chassis adjustment and an air pressure adjustment, four tire change, trying to help Denny's car roll through the center of the corner better. Alan?
Add Carl Edwards an air pressure adjustment on his car, four tire stop, and they get him out first off of pit road. We'll see where that puts him on the restart.
We'll sort out the scoring when we come back to New Hampshire. 54 laps to go. Could be pretty interesting with Clint Boyer coming from the back.
Green flag, green flag.
Carl Edwards is the race leader as the green flag comes out at New Hampshire. Clint Boyer has led 127 laps today. He's clearly had the best car. Was caught on after pitting by a caution flag, is the lucky dog, but by rule has to start at the tail end of the longest line.
Yeah, I was thinking that he would be in front, but you're right, Bill. He had to go all the way to the end of the longest line. It's going to be fun watching him come through this traffic. Not for him, but for us.
Scored in 16th on the restart.
The problem with all that is that Carl Edwards has got a fast race car. He's out front. And he's going to be gone by the time Boyer gets through all this traffic. Yellows will play into his favor if they get some caution flags, but it's going to be tough to make that track position up.
Saw Kyle Busch, who also was on pit road just before the caution came out. He's 17th. That's Busch in the 5 car. He's at the tail end of the lead lap now. Here's our freecreditreport.com pit summary. Boyer went in as the race leader, then restarted 16th. Carl Edwards took over the lead. Harvick picked up a spot. That's the spot that the 2 car gave up. Allen.
And Chad Walter, talking about Kyle Busch, who's out there in front of the leader. You mentioned him a second ago, Bill. There he is in that 5 car. He's a mile behind, basically. His crew chief, Chad Walter, had planned on staying out another 7 laps, but I talked about earlier, he did not want to give up the speed on fresher tires to Clint Boyer that he would by pitting 7 laps later than Boyer. That's why he brought Kyle in. When the caution came out and they found out they were trapped on the tail end, he basically came on the radio and apologized to Kyle. One of those things that happens in racing, that's why those crew chiefs have a tough job.
Michael Waltrip just safely made it back to pit road after having what appears to be a left side tire going down.
I think he made some contact with another car on the backstretch, knocked a fender in on a tire.
It looked like a lot of damage on the left side of the car, but let's see if we can get a better look at it.
Watch the middle of the screen here.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Gets clobbered pretty good by Mike Wallace.
And there we see why Michael had to go to pit road to get that fender off the tire.
And a good job hanging on to it there, too.
And all Carl Edwards can do is watch this terrific battle between Dave Blaney in 32 and Kyle Busch in 5 as they try to be the first car in front of the leader. Or both cars right now are in front of the leader. They want to stay in front of Carl Edwards.
Because if the caution came out, they'd be back at the tail end of the lead lap, or back basically pick up a whole mile under caution.
But he needs to get by these guys, because if he looks in the mirror, he's going to see a couple of guys coming pretty hard. There's Jeff Burton with the left rear flat.
Wow.
Jeff was running in the top 10.
And the car normally driven by Bernie Lamar. Something else Carl Edwards can think about is that Clint Boyer has made his way to 11th.
Already? Yes, he has.
Marty Snyder.
Well, as you guys would imagine, you talked about Dave Blaney right ahead of Carl Edwards in that yellow 32 car. He's extremely frustrated right now because they've had a top 10 car all afternoon long, and this is exactly what he was worried about. He said his car just will not handle in the middle of the corners, and he can't keep it down enough to keep Carl Edwards behind him. He's trying, but it's awfully hard. Alan.
Marty, it's kind of a dilemma for Carl Edwards. And Benny and Wally, you've both been in this situation before as drivers. How hard does he press to clear these lap cars, knowing Clint Bowyer's coming back from behind, and he's got Kevin Harvick right behind him as well? Or does he need to pace himself, save some fresh tires for the ending laps of this race in case Bowyer gets there later? How hard do you press him? How do you make that decision, right?
I think, Alan, if you've got a really good car, which looks like Carl has, I think I would be pressing it. The 32 is obviously struggling right now, so I would try to get to his bumper and loosen him up so I can get by him, because right now you've got to put as much distance as you can. You know Bowyer's coming, and the only way you're going to get away from Bowyer is on clean racetrack. These guys are holding him up. Also, you look in the mirror and you got Harvick and Hamlin right behind you, so I think you've got to press.
There's a guy that's pressing, Clint Bowyer.
But look at all that traffic that he has in front of him. He just can't. He has to struggle so much to try to get through this traffic.
Picked up seven laps. Check that. Picked up six positions in seven laps, Dave.
The question I've got, Bill, though, is on this racetrack, if it stays green, he's still about 9 seconds behind the leader. Does he have enough time? Some racetracks, you can make up a lot of ground, coming back through the field if you've got the best car. But here, I don't know.
Here we go.
A lot of time to make up, Dave.
This is the race for second.
Contact right there.
Harvick in the 21 and Hamlin in the 20. This has been going on throughout the day.
And Paul Menard, that 11 car, has a great seat.
Now, we talked about this earlier. Okay, now Paul sees what's going on. So he's going to go, well, let me see. Let me let these guys rough each other up, and maybe I can turn underneath them and get them both.
This is the best thing that could happen to Carl Edwards, the leader. Look at the distance he's put on Harvick in second spot as those two cars try to race each other.
Dave pointed out that Clint Bowyer was 9 seconds behind the race leader. He's already knocked that down to about 7.5 and still trying to weave his way through traffic.
Yeah, what Bowyer needs really is a caution to come out to erase that 7 seconds and then get another run at it. He obviously has a fast race car, but it's going to be tough to make 7 seconds up on the racetrack.
Working on John Andretti and Stacy Compton. That's not for a position on the leaderboard, but it's for position on the track. Carl Edwards up front, the Missouri native, trying to get another win in the NASCAR Busch Series. 34 laps to go here in New Hampshire. Carl Edwards, the race leader, by about 6/10 of a second over Kevin Harvick. Denny Hamlin has fallen about a half second behind him. Then it's Paul Menard in the top four. Hey, race fans, Brass Eagle, the world leader in paintball equipment, is offering a VIP Nextel Cup race weekend sweepstakes. Visit BrassEagle.com/TNT for more details.
Paintball, you ever do that? Paintball?
I was just thinking about it. Have you ever been hit by one?
No, I haven't.
I've got some.
I was afraid of that.
I'd love to shoot you with one.
But I can't wait to get the Pocono then.
Carl Edwards having a fine run. Clint Bowyer is in the ninth position and now 9.4 seconds behind Edwards. Pitted under the green, then the caution came out. Bowyer has led 127 laps.
Yeah, Bowyer doesn't have a shot, I don't think, unless we get a caution.
But we had a similar situation here a year ago. Didn't we, Alan?
Yeah, we did, Bill. Martin Truex Jr. hit it on lap 159 in this race. And I believe it was 12th. He restarted, came back through to take the lead for the final time. Inside the final 15 laps, it can be done. The difference between last year and this year, Truex was on a little bit fresher tires than some of the guys he was passing. But boy, I'll tell you, the strongest Bowyer's car's been today. Of course, I'd like to take the opposite side from Wally on anything anyway, but I might have to question that one, Wally.
But AB, was there no cautions in those laps?
No, there were several cautions, and I do agree with what you're saying, that he does need some yellow flags to close that gap up to Carl Edwards. If he can get a couple, it might be really fun those last few laps, huh?
Sure would. And we'll have to find out from Dave what Bowyer's tire situation is, because if the caution was to come out, the race leader's going to stop or not. What's Bowyer's tire situation down there, Dave?
Four fresh ones, Bill. Four fresh ones.
The window strap.
He's got them. He needs them.
Okay. What were you looking at, the 11?
There was a window strap on the 11 car that's loose right there.
There you go. So NASCAR taking a look at that. Menard runs in the fourth position. He's about 4 seconds behind Carl Edwards. Then it's Harvick and Hamlin up front. Carl Edwards finished second here last July in his only Busch race here at New Hampshire. He's trying to become the 20th different winner in 20 races this season. Let's take you through the field real quick. Carl Edwards is up front. Let's start with Alan.
And the man who will slide into the picture in the upper left is his crew chief, Pierre Cotel, a veteran Nextel Cup Series mechanic, but new to the crew chief's role this year. When he took the job, he wondered, would I be able to get it done? Well, they won at Charlotte Memorial Day weekend, again at Nashville in June. Pierre Cotel trying for win number three as a crew chief today, Matt.
The guy trying to chase him down is Kevin Harvick twice. He has finished second here in New Hampshire, trying for that first W. Hasn't said much, but the car a lot better at the beginning of the run compared to the past two runs today, Dave.
Denny Hamlin started the day third, runs third, but it's been a frustrating day trying to get to the front and get around Kevin Harvick, frankly. Car is tightest it has been all day. Denny not happy right now.
And Paul Menard following Denny Hamlin on the track in his 11 car. Menard won in his home state of Wisconsin last month. Well, he's got his car chief, shock specialist, tire specialist, and two mechanics from New England on this team. They'd love a great finish today, Marty.
Alan, this has been a terrific day for Johnny Sauter. Started 14th, currently he's in fifth. And if he can finish here, it would be his first top five finish of the season. Johnny with an awesome effort this afternoon. Scott Riggs behind him. Believe it or not, this team has not finished in the top 10 since Bristol back in the spring when Riggs did it, and he finished sixth in this race car. Having a fun time today, currently in the sixth position, Alan.
J.J. Haley's team's made so many adjustments on the day, just about need a second pad to write them all down, but they persevered. You see, he's picked up 10 spots, and he's up to seventh as the laps run out. And a great persevering day for Scott Wimmer as well. A lap down earlier, got the lucky dog back just before the last restart. His crew chief, Newt Moore, said, I see a top five in your future, Scott. Dave?
The good news for Clint Boyer was that he was the lucky dog, but there wasn't a lot of joy back in the pits here. I think they knew the task at hand. If it stayed green, it has, and he still has it cut up to the leaders, guys.
Hasn't worked out for him, Dave. He runs ninth. Greg Biffle rounds out the top 10. There are 15 cars scored on the lead lap. Just 19 laps separating Carl Edwards from his third Busch win of the year. NASCAR Busch Series Racing from New Hampshire International Speedway on TNT is brought to you by Nextel. Get closer to the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series with Nextel from Sprint. By AmeriQuest Mortgage, proud sponsor of the American Dreams. And by Subway Restaurants. Subway, drive hard, eat fresh. 14 laps to go, and Carl Edwards out front by 0.8 seconds over Kevin Harvick. Then it's Denny Hamlin, Paul Menard, and Johnny Sauter in the top five.
But you said 0.8. Folks, that's not much.
How about the leader, Alan?
Bill, you know, what race drivers like to do most is race, right? Well, already this week, Carl Edwards well into an Ironman attempt here in New England. He ran a 100-lap dirt modified race up in New York on Wednesday night. Then he came here, practiced and qualified a NASCAR Whelen modified tour machine. He raced that earlier today, was involved in a crash, came up some laps short of the scheduled 100-lap finish. Now 200 laps in the NASCAR Busch Series car today, 300 laps in the Nextel Cup Series car tomorrow. That adds up to over 600 laps of racing in a week to me, and I know my math is shaky, Wally, but you'll go with me on that one, won't you?
I'll go with you on that.
That's a fun week for a race driver, getting behind the wheel for that much time and picking up a trophy on top of it.
Not
priceless.
Not bad.
Priceless. There you go.
There's Clint Boyer.
Trying to take over that sixth position from Scott Riggs in the nine car.
This is about 9 seconds behind the race leader. Clint Boyer led 127 laps in this race. He pitted under green. Then the caution came out. He was the lucky dog, had to restart at the tail end of the longest line. So he restarted 16th on lap 150. It was about 40 laps ago. He's only been able to make his way up to about the seventh position.
Harvick a little quicker. He's been a little bit quicker than Edwards the last couple of laps, Kevin Harvick has, but not by much.
We talked about the two-car Clint Boyer. He and Kyle Busch in the five-car both pitted about the same time, just before the caution flag came out. Boyer caught the lucky dog. Yes, he had to start at the end of the longest line, but he's battling and taking over the sixth position. Kyle Busch is back in 16th position because he is still right. One lap down.
Yeah. Raced hard to try and stay on the lead lap, but couldn't do it. Boyer gets that position, but he's going to run out of laps.
Yeah, it just kills you, too. I mean, he's very... I mean, to have a dominant car like he's had, and just have that caution come out just the wrong time, when you know you've got the best car out there and you can't capitalize on it, just very, very heartbreaking.
His consolation prize today might be the fact that this car is so good, he can take some of that information and put it in his cup car because he wasn't overly happy with that.
Very small consolation.
That's what I said.
Let's jump
I said small
win.
Consolation.
Yeah.
Carl Edwards on a roll in the last seven races in the Busch Series. He won at Lowe's, won at Dover, and a top five finish in five of the last seven.
And I'll tell you what, I said earlier that Blaney was a slower car holding him up. He swung right in there, stayed on the lead lap.
And Carl Edwards is now just 7/10 of a second in front of Harvey. I realize we're only 5.5, 6.5 laps to go, but.
And I think Carl probably saw that 21 car coming in the mirror and decided, you know what, I better step this thing up a little bit. I got 10 laps to go, and I better drive this car a little bit harder.
Allen?
Yeah, well, one of the things that's happened there, Bill, Benny, and Wally, is that Carl Edwards has gotten up behind Dave Blaney, and the aerodynamics have come into play. The proximity to Blaney's rear spoiler there has taken some of that downforce off the nose of Carl's car. He can't turn as well as he needs to cut and go by Blaney. And really, what's the motivation for Blaney to let him go at this point? He catches a caution and he could come right back around and get in the hunt. There is no lucky dog inside the final 10, so Blaney shouldn't move over for him.
And Harvick is hustling.
Picked up almost 1/10 of a second that last lap, and we can see that Harvick is gaining on Carl Edwards.
And Edwards can see it.
Yes, he can.
In his rearview mirror. Harvick has not led a lap today, but has been inside the top five most of the afternoon.
I was going to say, Harvick's running a little bit different line, but maybe it's because Scar is pushing, but he is running a little bit higher through the corners than Edwards is.
See, once again, Harvick faster than the leader.
Five to go.
Down the backstretch.
Now a lot of traffic in front of Carl Edwards, so he's got to get going.
And Harvick talked about, and we followed it through most of the day, how his car did not handle well when he got trapped behind somebody else.
Well, the problem is with Harvick too is Kevin's using a lot of racetrack to go fast. It's gonna be really tough to get side by side and race somebody when you're needing the whole track for those kind of times.
And Blaney moves over the 32 car and lets Edwards and Harvick go by. Class move by that young man because he realizes that we have a race for the win coming up.
That was really classic.
Yeah, it really was.
Because he's fought long and hard for that position.
He stayed in front of him for what, 20, 30 laps.
Kenny Wallace on the inside. Leaders go by.
Now Edwards has clean racetrack in front of him.
Harvick's trying to get there. 2.5 to go. Two to go this time for Carl Edwards. Harvick in his mirror, but can't get to his bumper.
Two to go, man. Two to go.
Clint Boyer has made his way to sixth. 7.5 seconds behind Edwards.
And Carl's car is just getting through the center of the corner just a little bit better. Harvick can get in the corner a little bit better. But Carl can get through the center and on the gas better than Kevin Harvick.
Kevin Harvick finished second here in 2001 and 2003. White flag is out. Last time around for Edwards. Benefited from a caution after the two race leaders have pitted. Down the backstretch for the final time. So Carl Edwards with a racing doubleheader ran the modified race here earlier and takes the checkered flag at New Hampshire. Edwards wins in Loudon, holding off Kevin Harvick.
It's over, right?
Yeah, it's over. Carl, it's over.
It's over. Good job, guys. Man, that's awesome. Great work. That's fun.
Clint Bowyer got to fifth.
Johnny Sauter, where'd he come from? He's sixth.
Yep. Strong run for him. But again, it's like you talked about.
Yeah, I really appreciate it, guys. That was fun.
Johnny's got a lot of laps at Milwaukee. This track very similar to Milwaukee.
And Menard, who was the winner in Milwaukee, finished fourth. So
you were right. Is that what you want to? Is that what that card you're holding up says?
Yes.
Benny was right. Good job, BP. And we all know what's coming now.
Donut, you think?
No, backflip.
Oh, backflip. Oh, yes, that's right.
All right.
This is the flipper. Oh, yeah.
Fourth win of the season. And no grass here in New Hampshire to do it on. Driver to win in the 20 races here in New Hampshire. His eighth Busch Series win. His third win of 2006. He's going to celebrate. The fans will look on. We'll take a break. Then we'll take you to Victory Lane. Carl Edwards, the race winner here in New Hampshire. Carl Edwards has made it to Victory Lane here in New Hampshire, and the celebration is about to continue. Let's go down to Matt Yoakum.
20 different NASCAR Busch Series races on the Magic Mile, 20 different winners, and Carl Edwards makes it an exciting one. Second here 1 year ago, and he has said awesome about nine times to his guys. Now, a perfect 10 on the backflip, but he almost wipes out here in Victory Lane. What were you thinking when you saw all those lap cars in front and Harvick start to reel you in?
I've got to send Dave Blaney a Christmas gift, man. That was really nice. I don't know what it has to be Haas is, but I stared at that backside of his car for a long time. And yeah, those Busch cans are slippery. Man, I just can't thank my team enough. I really have to thank the Bodine Bobsled guys for letting me drive their modified. Wrecked it this morning, but Ameriquest and Henkel and this Fusion really came through, man. That was a blast.
Especially after the up and down month of June that this team had.
Yeah, that was, and I have to say, Clint Bowyer, man, it's cool. He was so fast and he just got some bad luck. But yeah, after that month we've been having, this is great. Hopefully it carries over tomorrow, man.
Roller coaster month of June, back in Victory Lane in July. His first win here on the Magic Mile. To Marty Snyder.
Well, Matt, Kevin Harvick finished his second and walked me through those final few laps. Looked like you were tracking Carl Edwards down for a little while, but you just couldn't get to him. Why?
Yeah, I caught him and just got about five from him, and he got by the 32 and just kind of started to pull away. But all in all, a good day for our U.S. Coast Guard Chevrolet. Car was a little bit loose there in the middle of the race and a little tight there at the end, but guys did a good job and just got to keep at it.
Kind of an interesting day with you and Denny Hamlin. What started all of that?
Just a bonehead driving down the back stretch, running into the back of me. So he, you can't run into the middle, into people in the middle of the straightaway and not usually cause a problem. So just, rookie move, I guess.
And so far, those two have yet to talk, although Kevin did give him a little bit of a stare earlier on. Dave?
With Clint Bowyer now, who dominated this race, but obviously the caution coming out at a bad time, what went through your mind when you saw that caution?
Trouble. Just plain trouble. But all the guys in the AC Delco Chevrolet, they've been working hard, digging deep, and we got this thing turned around and going in the right direction. We keep knocking on the door to our first win of the season. We're going to get it. Just Lady Luck's not on our side, and sometimes you need a little luck, and unfortunately we didn't have it today, but like I say, we're coming.
And you wish you could have this car tomorrow, but you can't.
Yeah, this hot ride's pretty fast. I learned a lot, though. Definitely learned how to pass. I passed a lot of cars, and call Gail over on the Sylvania Chevrolet tonight, and hopefully we can come up with a good package. It'll be good tomorrow.
Disappointing end of the day for the two car. Alan?
With Paul Menard, started 25th, finished fourth today. That was a hard day's work, Paul.
Yeah, we
Really didn't qualify as good as we hoped. Just got really loose in qualifying, kind of screwed up and tried overdriving it. But we knew we had a really good race car. My boys didn't let me down in the pits. They gave me awesome pit stops. I gained a lot of positions there, and spotter Stevie Reeves kept my nose clean out a couple of those wrecks too. So all in all, pretty good day. You know, fourth place is pretty good for the Sylvania Menard Chevy. You know, starting 25th is a long day.
He came in seventh in points, a good day on that front. Marty?
Well, Alan, we got the Kevin Harvick side of the story. Let's get the Denny Hamlin side of the story. So what started that incident with you and Harvick?
You know, it was a restart, and cars were sliding around a bunch, and I think he was going for a position on Bowyer, and I got to the outside of him off of two, and, you know, don't know whether his fault or not, you know, with a spotter or what it was, but, you know, he moved up, and I was up there, and ended up putting me in the wall, so I nudged him down the back straight away, and just for a little displeasure what he did, but you know, I wasn't going to wreck him or anything like that, so I released him before we got to the corner, and then every time after that, you know, we went at it, but still, that's water under the bridge, so with, and we'll go on next week.
Plan on going to chat with Kevin after this?
I don't know. I mean, we hadn't had a problem all year, so, you know, he's not too upset, I'm sure, and you know, I'm not too bad myself.
Real quick, it was a nice top five run, which you told me you needed this morning.
Yeah, we really did. We definitely had to do what all we could to get a top five, and proud of this whole Rocco Automation crew.
And Denny told me this morning, you know, we just had a lot of frustrating runs lately. Top five is really all I want today, and that's what he got, Bill.
That's right, and he heads to Pocono next week with the Nextel Cup Series, where he got his first career win. Here's our Holiday Inn race recap. Carl Edwards in victory lane. Here's how we got there. The crowd on hand at New Hampshire, taking the green flag.
This guy just dominated the race. Two car, Clint Bowyer. I mean, he had the car to beat today. No question about it.
But on lap 57, see the 33 car throws his glove out the window. NASCAR held him for two laps for causing a caution flag.
He was very interesting on the radio, too. Some contact today, wild ride.
Tracy Hines in 12 gets in the back of Peyton Sellers in 31. Curtis Davis in 0 also involved.
Lap 89, Sorensen in the middle.
Not a good place to be going into turn one at Loudon. Gets spun sideways and a couple other cars get turned around, make some contact.
Carl Edwards benefits from a caution that really hurt Kyle Busch and Clint Bowyer. The winner in Loudon. I see Scott Riggs, and I think Matt's down there somewhere.
Bill, he's debriefing with Tripp Bruce and Kenny Childers. So, first off, very solid run for a team that really needed it.
Yeah, these guys did need it. They've been struggling a little bit here lately, but they do a great job. And, you know, I always tell them we always have an extra day to play with our car and work on our cars on the cup side. And these guys got to make decisions and split decisions. And Tripp does a good job on this Wiss Dodge today. And had a miscue on the pit stop, the first pit stop, and lost a lot of positions. But I just hung in there and got a great pit stop the next time. Car just never was really good across the center of the corner. But, man, it's a pretty fun day being a Busch car.
Learn any trends that you can carry over till tomorrow?
We just learned more about the cars. You know, the cars are pretty close as far as direction they're set up. So I learned a lot about the tires and learned a lot about the track. And, you know, just like I say, we're trying to pull every bit of information out of Tripp here as we can before tomorrow.
Finished seventh here in New Hampshire. Bill.
Thank you, Matt. Good run for Riggs and a big win for Edwards. Wins the 200-mile Busch race on Saturday, performs the backflip, and turns his attention to Sunday at New Hampshire. Third win of the year for Carl Edwards. Drives to victory here in New Hampshire. Look at the unofficial results. Clint Bowyer led 127 laps.
That's the guy in fifth place. What a shame.
Kyle Busch started on the pole. He led 15 laps early. Finishes back in 16th.
Mike Wallace finishes 12th. Thought he might have a top five car today. Maybe even a winner. 12th was the best he could do.
And a lot of these guys had trouble. Jeff Burton had a flat tire. Same for Michael Waltrip after contact on the racetrack.
And there we see some guys that had trouble.
Lots of trouble. Look at the championship standings after 20 races, and Kevin Harvick over 300 points in front of Carl Edwards. Tomorrow on TNT, it's NASCAR Nextel Cup Racing from Loudoun. Ryan Newman leads the field to the green flag. Jeff Gordon going for back-to-back wins. Coverage begins at 1:30 Eastern time tomorrow on TNT with the Bank of America countdown to green. Next on TNT, don't miss Brad Pitt, Morgan Freeman, and Kevin Spacey in 7. Carl Edwards wins the Busch race. We'll see you tomorrow from New Hampshire.